Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're playing some more Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. And in the previous episode, we killed Surt, which means we have killed both bosses, obtained their masks, or the key to get to Helheim's Bridge, I believe. So this episode, we're going to be doing that. This episode also might be a bit longer because I just want to play this game, man. I'm so obsessed with it, and only playing half an hour chunks is killing me. So yeah, guys, that is the plan for today's episode. I said episode a lot, I'm sorry. And let's get into the gameplay. Mwah.
Have you ever died before?
Okay, so
it's a serious question.
We have been through this before in the previous episode, but we'll just have as a little recap.
Shattered. You simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died. And she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
With the mark of
okay, guys.
With the mark of Surt, you may cross
yes.
The bridge over the River of Knives.
Let's go to Helheim. To Tilion. Fingers crossed we don't die. We still are only on one death.
It's dangerous. Don't open the gate.
She's still alive.
What? I don't see a bridge.
It's so dark. It's dark. The darkness.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the dead may cross into
the gate. Oh my god, this is creepy. I would be shit scared if I was her.
Truth? Anyone?
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved.
Damien!
Oh shit. Go, go, go. Run to him. Or casually walk.
To pull through. When you were in love, you left him in tears to smother your furies and banish your fears.
This guy is dropping bars right now.
But in darkness they came. Through stormy black seas they raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now at your home. He's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him in your sword still beats. A heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for
oh my
your
god.
Dreams. Now there's no way to win.
That's awful.
In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home.
No!
They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness, you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart.
I don't really know what to say to that. That was actually like super powerful. Some sick bars, I can't deny it.
The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon, to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Okay, guys. So we're crossing the bridge now. Ah, look who it is. Some dickheads. Fuck you.
It's your calling. Everything. gate you open into darkness brings another charge.
Shit. Get up. Get up, get up, get up. Who the fuck is this?
Quick, get up. She's hurt. She won't make it.
Oh.
journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours.
Okay, right.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hel, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hel to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
What the hell? I'm not sure what's going on.
Possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high satiates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold, all will stumble. Her bed is called sickbed.
Here we go.
And her bed hangings are called flaming funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh. And her face, menacing and grim.
She sounds like a butter skirt. If you don't know what that slang means, it means ugly. Okay, we've done it, guys. Yay! What's the bet? We're gonna fight some more creatures through here.
Disgrace. The gods will punish you for this.
How the fuck am I supposed to fight that?
Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it.
This is where I die and lose the game.
Get up. Get up and fight.
Deep inside of her. Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares.
Sorry
Maybe
about the plane, guys.
I feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Curse. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win?
Oh my god. That voice is her speaking to herself.
She's a curse.
She's actually Colm.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself. Because there's no one left to do that for you.
Damn. Calm down, Colm.
If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your
son. Remember, Dillian sent you up. Come on.
Why go on when you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined? Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
Like, why would you burn yourself? Maybe to punish herself, but it's gonna make her weaker, so that was a bit of a stupid move.
Met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others.
Oh, crap.
Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbal, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains.
Okay, she's a bit stronger now. We can see him up there.
That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
What's down here? Just have a quick look. It seems a bit different to going up there, but I'm intrigued. Mother! Give me strength, Mother.
Senua, there will be times that you will feel alone and exhausted, like a strange little fish swimming against the tides of the big ocean. But have the faith to let go and let the tide carry you away. Because the whole ocean is your home, and it does not ask you to swim against it.
Some of them. Like, this stuff makes you really think. Not gonna lie. Like, I really admire how this game is about mental illness. I don't think it's really spoken about enough, to be honest.
Nothing lives here, not even you.
Like, I'm sure, like, you guys have suffered a fair amount of mental illness, as have I in the past. Sometimes I still do.
Ray of hope.
hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch.
Like Thor.
His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses it. So King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast when they arrive.
Okay, I don't know why that died out. Maybe you have to be nearer to hear it, but... my bad. We're heading to the tree, though. The tree to meet Dillion. I think it's just up there. Oh, there's mountains and everything as well. So yeah, as I was saying earlier, like...
day after day.
Mental illness should not be something to be ashamed of.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not... I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
you... learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillion. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
Oh, he's so nice to her.
Well, you can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him.
Yes, Senua.
They will never
believe.
Let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
Tell them. Fight the demons in your head.
Dillion? Is that you? I'll find you. I promise.
Into the tree.
Can you see him? You want to believe it. Is he not real? Is he there?
But we can't go straight up to it.
Nothing lives here. You won't survive.
Yes, I will, you stupid sluts.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
I need to get around there. Hang on.
He's waiting for you by the tree.
I don't think he is, because he's dead. But you know, we can hope.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister. And she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left.
You want to hear the story out, guys?
The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again...
She ate the honey!
You'll never guess what happens.
What? Oh, for fuck's sake, I wanted to the end of that story. Okay, I'm gonna guess... Oh, that's all of it, yes! I'm gonna guess that she ate the honey and became Sigmund's best friend. And then Sigmund used the wolf to destroy every motherfucker.
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood.
That'd be a sick screenshot. Okay, right, I think there's another one over here that we can listen to before we go up to the tree. So let's just do this quickly. This story is really good. What? This isn't one. Well, that's fucking bullshit. God damn it. What is this for then? Oh well, okay. Let's go into the tree. Like I said, guys, this episode's gonna be a bit longer. Just because I have a lot of stuff to get through as well. So I hope you don't mind that. You also find when you play a bit longer, you can get into the gameplay a bit more in the story. Guys, that's gonna have to wait until next episode.